Lots of Nigerians are talking about social media bill. Now, in case you didn't know, Nigerians are big fans of social media, but the Nigerian government, not so much.
We can also regulate our social media. We must not allow the social media to plunge us into war.
They go to social media, they do all sorts of things. I'm even scared to give my young children phones because I'm scared I don't know what they would see on the social media. It's that bad.
Now they want to follow in the footsteps of countries like Tanzania and Burkina Faso by regulating the country's social media space. Now, there have been failed attempts to regulate social media in the past. The Protection from Internet Falsehoods and Manipulations and Other Related Matters Bill, was proposed. Its aim, according to the senator who introduced it, is to curb the spread of false information and fake news, which many Nigerian politicians, including the Minister for Information, have said threatens the stability of the country.
We need a policy on national policy on social media. We need also to empower the various ministries, the Minister of Information, on how to deal with social media. And we need the technology to be able to shut down at will. Social media will become a menace to the country's security.
The bill says people should not transmit false statements or statements that might affect the country's security, public health, public safety, public finance, Nigeria's relationship with other countries, influence election outcomes, or cause hatred towards a person or a group of people. Anyone found guilty of these things could face a fine of 300,000 naira, 3 years imprisonment, or both. Companies face a fine of 10 million naira. The bill would also give the government power to turn off the internet. When it was first introduced, the bill drew a lot of criticism, with activists concerned that the bill was an attempt to clamp down on free speech. And now the End SARS protests, which were largely driven by social media, have put the bill back on the top of the news agenda, which has some Nigerians very concerned.
Every time there has been either a protest or there have been active voices speaking up against government, we have seen pushback by government, because government by nature loves control. Some of the reasons why people do not want it include vague statements that have been used in the past to either attack active citizens or members of the opposition or even people in civil society. Phrases like false statement. You cannot vest the power to determine what is false statement outside a court.
Another criticism of the bill is that Nigeria already has laws that cover defamation, slander and libel, which activists say is enough coverage for false statements.
We already have, for example, even a very punitive cybercrime law from 2015 that has been used by many people, including government officials, including private actors, to sue people who they feel have provided disinformation online or even things they considered hate speech. And so there are existing laws, and it begs the question then, why did desperation to now create a specific law that is targeted at social media if the problem is disinformation or fake news or dangerous speech or hate speech? Then let that be the problem that we will seek to solve. The problem is not the citizens. The problem is not social media. The problem is what we need to solve, not to mute public opinion.
As the fate of the social media bill waits to be seen,
many Nigerian social media users are vowing to fight it.